Hey guys, it's Blake, and today I'm just gonna do a little bit of lightning on this connecting rod here. Just clean it up, because you know these things aren't casted perfect, and you can see some ridge lines that don't really need to be there. Obviously, strength is our main thing. You can also see some edges down there, maybe, if my camera would focus, that don't really need to be there. So I'm just gonna knock those down a little bit. Make it nice and smooth. That'll hopefully knock a little bit of weight out of it. But obviously, I care most about strength and this piece of the engine. But I mean, who knows? We might be able to drill it. I've seen drilled connecting rods before, although they are somewhat uncommon. So I don't know. I'm probably not going to film any time lapse of me doing this because it's just kind of whatever, pretty self-explanatory, and I'll just show you what I took off when I'm done with it. But I'll probably be using a combination of one of these little, I guess, sandpaper grinder wheels, and possibly one of these bits right here. If you can see that, yeah. All right, so I'll see you guys when I'm done taking it off. You guys can see what I've done so far. Cleaned up the top there because it had some ridges that didn't need to be there, and the same with the bottom here. And now I'm gonna drill this one. Might not be the best thing to do, but I'm pretty sure I got an extra if it doesn't end up working out right. And you're gonna, since this is an I-beam construction, you're gonna want to do right here in the center of the channel. And so yeah, I'm gonna see how it goes. How's that? All right.
Hours later.
Alright guys, so basically that right there is what we accomplished. Now I'm gonna go in by hand and try to make these more triangle shape. The only reason I'm doing that is because, you know, if what I've been told my entire life is true, triangles are strong. So yeah, let's get her done.
1 eternity later.
Okay guys, so just to show you what I've done, drilled another center hole in here. The holes that were there and there, I put this in the vise. Then I used a carbide bit on the Dremel, and this is some pretty hard steel. So just take your time, use a carbide bit of some sort, and some hand files. Take your time and chug on. And you should be able to get it pretty good if you're wanting to do this. But this is, messing with rods like this is pretty risky business, so just keep that in mind. So the only thing I think I'm gonna do to it yet is I'm gonna try to strip all the copper cladding, copper plating off of it, and polish it up. And you shouldn't really worry about that in a small engine, especially not in a race engine, because the reason that cladding is on there is for treatment, at least from what I can understand. So when they're heat treating this rod or whatever, this metal, they clad it in that copper. So then something to do with temperature differentials and stuff, so it ends up making the beams a little bit softer than the rest of it, so then that way the beams aren't too brittle and whatever. I don't know, it's kind of confusing, but it doesn't really matter. for our purposes now, because one, it's not being treated, it's already been treated. Two, we're gonna have it in the engine, and it's not gonna get hot enough that's gonna need any of that to protect it or anything, so yeah.
Day two.
Alright guys, so there, if you can see, I've gone. I took this just to the wire wheel and stuff and kind of polished it up, knocked any burrs off of it. It's starting to oxidize in just a few spots because I didn't coat it in oil after I got done with it, but it's not bad. So that's a decent amount of weight reduction, but I don't know. I don't know. I might go back and take more later on, but for now, this is what we're going to run with. All right, guys. Thank you, and as always, if you want to see more of the Homelite Hotsaw build, subscribe, stay updated. And just another little thing, if you've watched this entire video up till now, got a few other projects going on. One is the 98 Screaming Eagle, which you've seen, a 98 Honda CR250. That's getting a little bit of work done, and we'll start to do videos on that here soon. And then I've also got another few projects coming along, but they'll be a little bit down the road. But I'm going to have an announcement video for them and see if you want them on this channel or a different channel. Alrighty guys, thanks. Have a good one.